Right. Hello, everybody, and welcome. I made it back in time, and a lot of news today. The Evocati server meshing test has begun. What I do see from the patch notes here, let me take a quick look. I'm loading in right now, so we have a very special one for you today that will help change the Star Citizen universe going forward with static server meshing. In this first of, in a long series of meshing playtests, today's build will consist of shards with two servers statically meshed, with one running Stan and the other one running Pyro. We'll be able to choose which location you go into. We know you all would love to see Pyro again, but we would really love a healthy mix of both star systems populated to get the data needed for Ivan, Clive, Paul, and the whole server meshing team to continue to iterate and improve meshing. Don't use the jump gates. Okay. Stanton or Pyro may be selected when joining the game. It is not currently possible to travel between them. Once you have chosen a starting system, it will not be possible to change it later. Okay. So this is a big, this is big. This is huge. I'm going to start the scene. What's up, Joker? What's up, Shay? All right, so I'm gonna kick it over. So, I'm still loading up. And the ISC of the Idris popped up today. That was good. It was a good, good stream. Just about to head out. Have a good stream. All right, Shaved. Have a good one, man. So, as you know, the ISC was there and came out today and showed the interior of the Idris, which was really awesome from what I saw. And for those that are still willing to help Space Tomato, I still have the GoFundMe link in the description. So just giving you a heads up on that, and we'll go from there. So give me a moment, make sure this is working right here. So I'm loading in still, but the static server meshing, they're trying to get at least 200 people in the game, and Evocati's in there now. I would love to be in there myself, but so, get rid of that, and gonna jump in and kick it over. Okay, so hopefully everything will be working okay today. It was running rather smoothly yesterday, so we'll see what happens. All right. I did put a message out that if due to being out with the family today that it may start late. Usually I start around 4 o'clock, 4:30, but I was out with Mrs. Shadow and my stepson, and we spent some family time together, and something that was needed. We haven't done that in a little bit, so I wasn't sure if I was going to be back in time, so I could have canceled, but I was able to make it back. Okay, everything's loading in. It's going to take a hot minute. So, with these patch notes for Iwakati, the main focus was to get at least, they said there was nothing new in Pyro today, but the main focus was to get in the system. They're trying to do 200 players in one shard with the replication layer. And have them meshed and with crash recovery. Big test. So hopefully it runs well. We'll see. And go from there. Everything is running well. Okay, we're good to go. So tomorrow, once I get done with some things for setting up and getting squared away. It is group bounty hunting tomorrow, and I will do that I'll start that kind of early so everybody can get in and enjoy it. And before the evening ends, once I get done here, I'm going to check out some S&B, see how that's running today. They put out some fixes, so I want to check into that. And of course, it's going to take a minute for me to get there. Man, I wish I could get in there and do some testing. That would be awesome. Moment. stuff's starting to populate now. Hey Scott, how you doing, man? Yep, waiting for the tram. And still haven't got my drink in my hand yet. Just got back on the theater watching Dune 2. It's epic. Nice. I haven't seen the first one yet, so. I will check that out eventually. And things are going to be running slow because of we got the test going on in the background. I want to see them both, and I will. Here we go. It's gonna be a minute. Whoops. Appreciate the likes, appreciate the views. Like I said, I'm running a little behind today.
Stand clear. Doors are now closed.
Hungry. And things are running way slow. Okay. So what's up, Scott? So next week I will be running the stream around 3:45, 4 o'clock my time for the next 8 weeks.
Vehicles, your vehicle has been delivered to the following location.
But the weekends are free to do whatever is necessary, what I need to do, and everything's all good.
Please visit us again.
Hangar 3. Hey, Miss Peaches, how are you? Thank you for asking, and how are things going along with everything? How's your daughter? How's life? Forgive me, I'm sorry, but I am hungry. Not right. Check. It's not supposed to come up. prospector mining and it wasn't working most of the time. But I named enough and bought the Starfighter, slowly building my fleet.
Launch complete.
What is going on? Yeah, it's a nice interface. Hello.
Hello, good evening, sir.
Hey, what's up, Brian?
Same old, same old.
I hear you. Same as always.
Did you have a good day?
Yeah. I believe that that interface may be interfering with the sticks. I don't know, Joker. It's weird. They all of a sudden started acting up when I updated to that beta. So what are you up to, Brian?
Little bit of this, little bit of that. Your family outing go good?
Yeah.
Good. There's nothing better than that old saying, tap the shoes, no place like home.
Right. Okay, let me get here. Lyria, pick up my rock. Bought a starfighter to build up your fleet. Awesome. It's good. Yeah, my game crashes when opening sometimes and I have to restart my fleet. I notice it just does it on a few games, but it works wonders. They just need to update it soon. Yeah, that's when I first used it. I started up with Skull and Bones and everything went dark and then it kicked back in. I was like, wow. Excuse me. But I am liking it. I had to reset a couple things. But what I do like is that you can actually do a total reinstall of the game the game ready driver from that. But I've been doing clean installs anyway, so when a new one comes out. I used to just do an express, but now I'm doing clean installs. It saves me a lot of heartache down the road. So what do you think, Brian? Server meshing.
Yeah, I see that. That's testing it out, and says that you can join either Pyro or Stanton, and Pyro is not fully developed or not complete, but you can't jump. If you do, there's a bug, and then you get Ibikati jail.
I don't know what that is. But that news in itself is awesome. It's a big step.
Hey, do you see that Google post about the one lady that was working for CIG? They did a... Oh, I just crashed. They did a...
interview with her or something?
Well, she was just saying they did a studio relocation after Squadron 42 was done.
Yeah.
And I think that's another reason why Pappy left, is because they were saying that the work environment was very toxic.
That I don't know. Can't be confirmed, because it's from one person, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, hearsay. Yep.
So I don't even bother with it. Don't even know. But yeah,
I mean,
I get what you're saying.
I could see it. I mean, look what they get all the time. I mean, all the tickets, you know, the stuff they're trying to bring out, the stuff they're working towards, how long it's been. I could see it, you know, sometimes it being a little bit, you know, every person moving, oh, well, you're at this title. Well, now you're at this title, but you switched between two, and now you're my boss, and now you're my boss at this time.
Too
many chiefs, not enough Indians.
Yeah, well, what can I say? I don't get involved in it. I don't talk about it, because I'd rather have confirmation before I say anything on anything about that. You know?
Right. But I could definitely see some, you know, now here in this time, you know, of their development of everything, that there could be a little bit of, you know, heated stuff, and, well, you know, we're getting this, and they want this, and, you know, well, we're doing this, you know, that's coming later, and we got this coming, but it has to mesh with this, and I could see they're under a lot of pressure. I get it.
Yeah, that they are. Well, like I say, and to be fair, we don't know all the particulars about anything, so...
Yep.
You know, that's why I don't even touch any of that stuff.
And you know, every single one of them are on the NDA.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Let alone Ibikati, just behind doors, NDAs are probably... I gotta sign one every day when I go to work.
Well, the main thing about that right now is the patch notes are public. They just can't have any images or any of that stuff out there. So,
got this join unavailable thing again. I'm going to have to do a whole restart.
No, you just join unavailable. You were in another server or what?
I was on yours, and I crashed, and I came back in. Now it won't let me.
It should let you come back directly to the one that you were on.
Nope. Join unavailable. On everybody.
Ooh. You may have to do a verify.
All I want to do is play.
And also, too, you got to remember, stuff is running in the background, so
Let's verify first.
So yeah, it's gonna be a interesting thing going on. Interesting. Never seen those before, but don't need them. Questions, comments, please feel free. Let me know what's up. Talk to me. And Brian, did you see the inside of the Idris?
I was watching it at work, but I had to stop watching it. Mm-hmm. We had the guy that we were working for that had a contract that we took wanted it off his books. So he gave it back, and then we had to meet up with the new boss and sign paperwork and all that good stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Just haven't had a chance. It's been a busy day. I had to do taxes today. You know, taxes.
Right.
I gotta pay.
I don't even get into that. That doesn't make sense to me.
Gotta pay Uncle Sam. Yeah, it's still not letting me have to verify. I'm gonna have to. Normally it happens when I restart, so. I'll give it a try. I'll be back, sir.
Alrighty. Trying to do this a little bit earlier today and have it all set up, but didn't get a chance to go and do that. So little too close. Okay. Hello.
I'm back.
Welcome back, sir.
Thanks for my time.
They changed the inventory at Kobe Blast at 18. What do you mean? Change the inventory. Artek.
Right back there. Mm-hmm. Loading up.
No, they didn't change the inventory. I did notice that it was jumbled. When I got in there, like, it wasn't set up like it always is, you know, once you put the filters on. Most of the ammo isn't for sale anymore? No. I found that I had to go from one kiosk to another to get the ammo to work right. To go and take a look, but I mean, I have to bounce from one kiosk to another sometimes. I've noticed that.
All right, it's working now after the restart.
Mm-hmm.
Logging on you.
Switching kiosk fixed it. Okay. Since I've been on, I thought they changed everything. No, not yet, but it's getting there. But, you know, that's going to come with the inventory, or not inventory, with the economy. What's going on with KP?
I don't know. I talked to him earlier today because I put him as emergency contact on my paperwork.
Mm-hmm.
But I haven't heard him. I'm just gonna see. Probably watching TV shows or went to bed early.
Oh, he was working extra hours, wasn't he?
I don't know if he still is or not. I got him on Google Maps. I can see if he's at work or at home.
I'll be checking on KP like that.
Oh, no, it's a family thing.
I know, I'm joking.
It's kind of see where everybody's at.
Mm-hmm.
Just in case, you know, something happens.
Right. I'll be right back. I'm going to go get myself a soda.
No adult beverage?
Nope, not yet. next week on that one. Okay. And coming up on Hurston.
Quantum travel.
So where are we rock mining at?
I'm going to Magda.
Oh shit, I brought the wrong outfit.
No, Magda's fine. Oh. You don't need a hot suit.
Yeah, I forgot about that. I'm wearing still my junk armor. I've been lazy to switch it out.
Shame on you.
I know it. Take a party invite.
Yeah, give me a moment.
Got it, thank you.
Mm-hmm. Still a little bit dark over here. Yeah, I'm gonna head down a little closer. Something down here.
I'm just now leaving 18, so I gotta go pick up my rock and I'll be around your way.
Alright. Well, you can pick it up at over here.
Alright, hold on, I got a phone call.
Yeah, almost hit the bullet. just jacked myself up in here. Holy crap. Gears not down. There we go. Interesting. Actually, let us not leave the lights on. Mark our position.
That HDMS Priam, is that someplace I can pick the rock up?
Yeah. Any mining facility.
Well, it didn't say it was a mining facility, at least.
What, HDMS Han or something like that?
No, Priam.
Perlman?
The one, but yeah, Perlman, where
yeah,
you're at.
Yeah.
Okay.
You can get that.
Well, of course. Oh, it did set the route. Alrighty. On my way.
Hello. What's up, Tone?
Hey, Tone, what's up?
Thank you. This is thank you. I really wish that there was some way to do something with the way things fall over and then they turn on their side and you can't get back up. What do you think, Brian?
Happens to me every morning.
Well, I'm not even going to touch that, dude. All right. What kind of rocks we got here? This looks promising. Had night. I'm on it.
All right, I'm in. Heading down to Perlman to get my rock, and I'll be right there.
Okay, let's see it starts sucking up. Hello.
Hello.
Howdy.
What's up, man?
Hey, what's going on, man?
Not a lot. Just bouncing in, see what's happening.
Not a whole lot. How's your back doing?
Doing better.
Good. Good. Yeah, just doing some rock mining right now. Checking it out. It is working It is working much better than before, so
have they still nerfed the payout on what you're getting?
I haven't tried it yet. This is my first attempt.
Oh, okay. I was on earlier today, and I was trying to sell some scrap.
Yeah.
Some RMC scrap, construction materials.
Yeah.
And pretty much system-wide, you can't sell it.
Interesting.
I tried across 3 different servers.
Wow.
And
RMC?
The construction stuff.
Oh, CM.
Yeah.
Interesting. Usually that doesn't have a problem.
Yeah, I went to Hurston, then I went out to the Cruel One, then I went over to the Stanton Jump Point, then I went back over to Area 18. Couldn't get rid of it nowhere.
Interesting.
Yep.
They must have done something, because it was working before.
Well, it could be that a whole lot of people are doing it, too.
Well, also, too, Jump Town started. So, you know how that affects some things.
Yeah.
And then they were doing that. And then they're also doing the back-end stuff for the new server. The new tech preview test.
Okay.
And
well, that's cool.
Yeah, with server meshing, so that's a big step right there.
Yeah. Really?
Uh-oh. Something's going on with this. What's happening? I think my ROC is damaged.
Oh.
Well, I just came here to Pearlman.
Yeah.
This latest patch, they took my ROC that I bought. So.
Oh, you gotta go buy one.
Yep. Yeah.
I understand where you're coming from.
I ain't doing that tonight, though.
Oh, you're doing that.
There goes my ROC. Damn it. It's so frustrating.
Why does this sound like a truck commercial?
It is so frustrating. I'm serious. I mean, they really could do something much better than what is happening. Hopefully. Nope. Yep, it's fried. Just got it, and it's fried. So.
Wow. All right, well, I'm going to let y'all get back to it. I'm going to jump off. Probably get in game here in just a second. I don't know.
All right, no worries,
man. All right, yep.
Good to see y'all. Take it easy.
Yeah, all right. Yeah, you too,
take
man.
Take it easy.
Yep.
Luckily, I'm not too
far
away.
That is one thing I didn't check to see if they took the ROC. They never gave him a Taurus back. I still got the Aurora, though. Thanks for the swap.
Yeah. That is just very frustrating. So, that ROC is abandoned, but I'm going to come back. So this one, luckily I didn't have to go very far. Yep, something blew up, and that's what jacked it. Luckily, I'm not that far away. Ah. But that is frustrating. I just got that thing, and I backed up far enough away where I wouldn't get damaged from an overcharged rock, and it still screwed it up. Gotta love it, Brian. Gotta love it.
Oh, yeah. SC baby.
Yep, it's SC baby. All right. But you gotta love it.
Yeah. The views are great.
Oh, well. When that Ibukati comes down and we get a chance to get into that test preview, I'm going to be all over that. I'm going to be all over it.
Don't go to Ibukati jail now.
No, because I'm not going to be silly enough to do that.
They tell you, oh yeah, you can jump and you can do it, but there's a bug, and if you do it, you're going to go to Ibukati jail. Like, what? Like, it's like taste but don't touch. They want you to do it.
Yeah, but you do it, you screw everybody because it messes up everybody's games.
Yeah, the server, the way it meshes. Yeah.
So you'll be in Ibukati jail. Don't want none of that business.
Whatever that means.
No, I couldn't tell you.
It says that you can do something, log out or verify or something, and you can fix it, but... You would think, before even Ibukati and their background testing, they would, you know, not even put that out. Hey, you can do this, but don't do it.
Well,
like, if you know it's already doing it, why you got told them? Oh, you can do it, but don't do it. You'll get in some type of freeze, or freeze the server or the meshing or the however it works.
Yeah, you mess
just
up
don't say it. Like, you know,
I don't know.
Don't put your foot in your mouth and then retract it. Yeah, just don't even say nothing.
Yeah.
Probably because they did, because when they did say that you could join either one or the other system, but Pyro's not complete. You know, which is fine. Uh-huh. You can see what's there, you know, enjoy it for what it is.
What in the world is going on down here?
Oh, at that, yeah, there's a bunch of junk there.
Okay. I was just wondering. Yeah, go ahead. Sorry.
I don't know. Just sometimes, just don't put your foot in your mouth. I mean, but then again, like, everybody would have rushed. Oh, you can get both? Can I go to one of those jump points and try it? But they're like, no, yeah, you... It don't work quite yet. We're trying to get it there.
Right.
So don't put it out to that. Just do it between yourselves in the testing phase between you developers. If you are sitting there and you're doing it, and you know that you can have both systems running on a server mesh, but you can't jump in that jump point to one to the other and it breaks it, then why even put it out to Ibukati alone? Like, you should fix it internally. Just my opinion.
Yeah. But, I mean, they gotta try it. You know, they got to.
Yeah, but they're saying try it, but don't try it, or you get Ibukati jail. Like, it don't make sense. Like, do but don't. Don't but do. Like.
Yeah, but the thing is, it's Ibukati. They're going to test it. They're going to do it. And, yeah.
Well, they got testing before Ibukati, though. Their own back in to their own testing, their own.
Yes.
So do it there.
Yeah. Because there's something account bound to the gates. You try to access the gates and they said it will abort the PU account.
Ah.
That's why. It can't cross over, is what you're saying, Artek, from one system to another.
Yeah, that's what they're testing, the server meshing, right? Correct?
Yeah.
Replication layer with the server meshing? Yeah. They're trying to get those two together, right?
Yeah, but if it's bound to the account, if it's bound to your account and you start off in that one system, you transfer over, it doesn't work.
So that's where they're, what they're testing then. Or trying to, assumingly.
Yeah, he says they haven't added that level yet. And that's why they're saying don't do it. Because it'll screw up everything.
But I thought that was the whole testing part. If you're stuck in one.
Yeah, but you got to remember, they're doing stage by stage. So
right.
They're trying to get the replication layer to work so when it goes into 23, it'll be set and all we have to do is just go right to 4.0. So, I don't know.
I got a question.
Yeah.
So how? What's the difference between the replication layer and the server meshing? I believe the server meshing is the systems and just the replication layer is the backup on the servers. Is that right?
The replication layer holds all the assets.
Which is the servers. And then the meshing is between the systems, Phantom and Pyro and the other ones.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm back.
What's up?
Not a lot. Just saying, eh? Getting in game.
Yeah.
Kind of strange.
But right now they're trying to have both systems mesh, but both systems disconnected. You choose system, stay there, try to jump, and get bugged account. They're testing one shard holding two systems of 100 players per each system, right?
Yeah, I read that, yeah.
But I mean, for what, for what they're doing, for what they're doing, this is a massive milestone. And I haven't heard anything that it's failed or anything like that. So they did get a green light and it dropped. So, and those that are in Evocati can talk about it now. So
wonder why they did that. It just caused more problems for them if you think about it.
No, because they were getting leaked anyway.
Yeah, they were. Yeah, exactly.
So
what was the whole Evocati NDA?
They can't divulge images, footage, or live stream it.
Just talk about it, so it's hearsay.
Yeah, so.
Well, yeah, but if you get ahead of it and you control the leak, a.k.a. create it yourself, then you can pretty much say anything as a leak, and it can, the accuracy can be questioned.
I wait for it to come from CIG. I don't mess with a whole lot of stuff like that because there's too many variables and
variables.
You know, it can get nasty and somebody could say, "Well, he said this," and it runs rampant. So yeah, no, I don't get into that.
Yep, story of human life.
Noah said it was gonna flood.
I'll speculate a little bit, but I will not get to the point where it's gonna be outrageous because that can get messy.
I understand.
Like how can I put it? If you go and say we're getting a full wipe, right? Before CIG says it. And CIG says, well, we're not going to do it. What happens? What does that, your credibility is a mess. Now, that's why I don't say anything about it.
Okay, I am currently at TDD at Area 18. And I cannot sell construction materials. Do I need to go to admin?
Yeah, try admin. What are we speculating? Let's make it good. If we're going to speculate anything, I will speculate the possibility of a small wipe, not a full, due to the fact that they really need to do some things to make things work. That's just my thought.
Well,
yeah, go ahead, Tom.
The thing about the partial versus full wipe is it puts everybody on a level playing field and it gets rid of broken assets.
Yeah, I know. But, I mean, they need to get the persistence down to the point where we're not losing consumables anymore.
Yes. Okay, and I can sell this at the commodities terminal.
Okay. And the Zeus, 23 or maybe 23.x. But if you get what I'm saying, what I'm trying to get a lot of people to understand, a full wipe doesn't do anything unless it's so corrupted that we got no choice. A partial wipe is not doing anything because we're losing things that we're buying. Persistence has to work. That's the key.
Yep, I agree. Nobody wants to keep playing something where you get wiped all the time, where it's rip. I mean, you can do that in a single player game all you want.
Well, you can do
play,
that.
play, save, do another new game.
Well, you get that. You get that in Tarkov. Okay. Escape from Tarkov.
Get that PUBG too.
Yeah. And, I mean, personally, I want to see the persistence work where I don't get wiped all the time. I want to see ships that I bought actually stay. I want to see ammo magazines stay. Drinks, all that stuff. Cargo containers, all that stuff.
I gotta take the dogs out.
When it gets to that point, then you can wipe all you want. Yeah. Get a fresh start and go for it. But you gotta have that persistence. That's gotta come.
All right. I was able to sell a cool 6 mil worth of construction materials.
Mm-hmm.
That's nice. You still mining, or did you give up on that?
No, I'm getting ready. I've got to move the ship a little bit.
Engines on.
But everybody thinks a wipe is going to solve everything. No,
it don't.
You've got to have the persistence in there. So when it goes to beta, we have a good beta test with it. And when it goes gold, there is no wipes. There are no wipes when it goes gold. It has to work.
That's correct.
So,
I mean, it's got to go to beta sooner or later because we're still in alpha, realistically.
Yep.
I mean,
oh my God.
A perfect game is tic-tac-toe. It's got to be that simple. Right. Otherwise, it's never completed.
Right. But I mean, I just wish people would. I'm not trying to be a jerk about it or anything, but wiping is not going to help the situation. You have to build. And you have to keep that build for a while to get things to work. And then they can wipe all they want.
Yeah.
But you gotta have that first, gotta have that first database where we won't have that problem.
I'm thinking about buying a ship. Do you have any recommendations?
What are you looking for? What are you
gonna I don't know. This is boredom shopping.
Oh.
Yeah, I've got
one just for the heck of it.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I was thinking about getting a Carrick. That's 26 million. I don't know if I want to blow that for that.
I pretty much, whenever I get a ship, I always get it for a specific purpose. So yep. That just depends on what you're looking to do.
Well, I immediately lost my Pisces medical.
Did you?
Yeah, I got it out, took it down, landed it, and they patched the game the next day.
Ugh.
Literally used it once.
Yeah, that's
cheap. I might get another one.
Yeah, they're dirt cheap, and they're going to be cheaper with the new when the new economy kicks over. But it all depends.
I'd like one of the new alien ships, but they're not for sale in game yet.
Which one?
The one that lands upright.
Oh, the Sulan?
Yeah.
That's 23. Most likely.
Yeah.
It's gonna be in 23.
The Osprey Talons are, I'm just over those. Osprey Prowler? Does that look like?
Oh, the Esprias?
The Espria Prowler, yeah.
Yeah, you can get the, I think you can buy that in game. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm looking at it. It's 4 million to 4.248. Well within the profit I just made. I don't even know what it looks like. What does it do? It's a combat Oh, that.
It's a dropship.
Got it. Never mind. I know what it is.
It's just a plain old dropship.
All right. Gentlemen, I just got reminded I got court at 8:30 in the morning.
Ouch.
Get you some rest, brother.
Have a good night.
They still saying, oh, we evidence, kind of get it. They ain't trying to say they ain't got no body cam, so it's going to be here safe. Police man.
Oh, he said, she said, he said.
Yeah, and they said they had their body cam going, but eventually they didn't, so they can't back up their story.
Oh, Lord, that's going to be a headache.
For them.
Yeah, right about that.
Boredom is why I haven't played.
Gentlemen, I'll catch you later, okay? Boss
right,
man,
take it easy.
I'll see you tomorrow.
All right, take it easy.
Have a good one.
Yep. Current ships just don't do it for me. Think Polaris, Zeus, and Apollos are going to do it for me. Mole is fun, but Arashtra is going to be much better. Oh, that's without a doubt. The Arashtra is going to put the mole to shame.
Yeah, I want it.
But I don't see that coming out for another year or so.
Yeah, there's got to be some capital ships action in game before that shows up. Plus, they have to ferret out how it's going to refine and hold large amounts of ore material.
Yep. So, I mean, if they release the expense, then the arrest will come next. True. But they've got to bring it out. They've got to show something that they're working on it. They should show it in white box or something.
Well, not knocking the ship as a whole, but there's got to be a way that it's niche so that it doesn't completely overwhelm the other two mining ships.
Yeah.
There's got to be a reason why you need the mole and the prospector.
Yeah. Well, those are tiers. Those are tiered ships.
Right. But for those of us that have a little bit of cash, we shouldn't be able to just come straight into the game, go buy the highest tier ore ship, go out and park in a mine in a field of asteroids, an asteroid belt, and just go to work. And just print money, which is essentially what's going to happen.
Well, like I say, there are certain ships that I am going to have, and those are what I'm going to start with. You know.
Now I do have an idea. It just dawned on me how that ship and the other two could work together as a group. You have the base ship, which is the one we're talking about. Mm-hmm. Then you have the feelers that go out, which is the prospectors, which is what their actually job is. Right. Then you have the moles that come behind them and get the larger asteroids mm-hmm. that technically cannot be mined by the prospectors. Mm-hmm. Then everyone meets up back at the mothership, unloads their product into the ship itself, and goes back out.
Right.
That's group activity, and they would literally, it would require 1 to 2 people on the big ship plus people on the moles and prospectors.
Yeah.
So I could see that being an org-wide deal there.
Mm-hmm.
I would love that. That would be awesome. But there again, money becoming an org money is what it would turn into.
Right.
So, because right now the turnaround on goods is low for the mineables.
Well, that's the thing too. When the mineables become very, very profitable.
Yes.
That is when things are going to change, because you've got base building. Everything that you pull is going to have a use in certain aspects, I guess.
Well, if you're going to need specifics like copper, aluminum, tin, iron, gold, then you actually have to go mine those specific elements instead of I'm getting quantanium today, tomorrow, and the next day so that I can go buy my carrick on the day after that.
Right.
And that's how we are used to mining. We're used to using it to print money.
Yeah, well, that's all going to change. That is all going to change.
It needs to, because right now that's all salvage is.
Yeah.
I mean, 250 per hit. Then you have your million and a half per reclaimed wreck.
Mm-hmm.
Rinse, repeat. And end of the day, you've made more in a couple hours than any new person could dream of making in a week.
Mm-hmm. But I mean, this is what I'm saying too. And a lot of people say they want to do the grind and all like that. Okay, you want to grind, but you won't see that until beta, and you really won't see it until the game goes live.
Grinding for the grinding's sake in the game is a wasted game loop, in my opinion. Yes, you need to work toward whatever tier ship you're comfortable flying and or can afford.
Mm-hmm.
Like in Elite Dangerous, if you crash your ship and blow it up, you got to have money to buy it.
Yep.
It ain't just a free turnaround. You literally have to. No fly without a rebuy is the way to go in Elite
mm-hmm.
Dangerous.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
If they instituted that in this game, you would see the game structure change dramatically in how people played it.
They wouldn't be, well, number one, they wouldn't be so doggone frivolous about killing people.
No.
I can't wait for that.
Well, I hear you.
Because, I mean, you know, right now, people just go around dusting people off for the hell of it. That's going to change, too. Mm-hmm. Because when Death of a Spaceman comes, people are going to be a lot more careful about doing stuff. And to me, Death of a Spaceman is a little extreme, but it is what it is.
Yeah. But I believe you should be able to determine the difficulty setting of your game based on how you want to play it.
Exactly.
Up front. If you want to play I'm here till I die, then I have to start over completely, then set it up to begin with.
Yep.
But you play primarily with that group of people. You don't play with a mix of just started and people that unlimited lives kind of thing, you know, that then that this they kill you just out of spite just to see you start over.
See, that's another thing. That's where it gets ridiculous. People, yes. Some people want that challenge of you lose everything when you die. And it's like, you know, it's a game. Come on, man. You know, I don't want to do that.
Well, I mean, this game's already hard enough without adding that to it.
Yeah.
Just saying. I mean,
Death of a Spaceman won't be bad. We have lives, even though. Yeah, I know our tech, but you know, some people are not into it. They think it's a bit extreme. They want it so realistic that you know, to me, that's just like. I might as well go to work every day. I might as well be working to play. You know, that's just how I see it. I don't know. Maybe I'm just weird.
Oh, you're fine.
But a lot of people want this thing to be such a life simulator that, you know, it takes a lot of the fun out of it for me. People do certain things that don't make any sense. Maybe I'm just weird.
Well, I play this to relax.
Actually, yeah.
And if I'm having to work at relaxing, then I'm not going to play this. I'm going to play Dark Souls. It's a lot more fun.
Yeah, see, I play this because I enjoy what it is, but when people start making it to the point where it's so much of it's that you're stressed out, it's not worth it.
Right.
And that's what it was like for me when I first started, because you didn't know. If you didn't have anybody to teach you the game, you were stressed out trying to play it. And I swore to God I would never let anybody go through that. So, if there's people out there that are listening or whatever, I will get with you and we all will get with you and show you how to play the game so you're not stressed out in your first week.
Yeah, I can do that. It's not a problem.
Yeah, I mean, sometimes I love playing with people and stuff like that, but there's sometimes where I get on and I'll just get in the ship and fly it. Just to relax my head and enjoy the scenery and the sounds of the ship and stuff like that. I don't do it very often, but it is a relaxing way to spend a morning with a cup of coffee sometimes. There we go. Extraction mode on. Much better. Yep, the rock is working much better. Even though when you start up, the arm goes up in the air, just hit M, and that'll even it out, and you'll be good to go after that. What's up, Dar? Dude, we got your VKBs. The worst time the company's on holiday for Chinese New Year the past few weeks. Just now back. All orders delayed with huge backlog of orders waiting to ship. Oh, that sucks. And the mining's going well so far. I busted one of my rocks. Yep, VKB is in China. Running a little kind of late today. right back. Going to see my... Goes, it finally caught up.
Yeah.
Extraction mode on. Fraction.
Now it catches up. There we go.
Having fun.
Hmm?
What's lagging so bad for you?
Oh, when it picks up the crystals.
Oh, yeah.
It's been kind of crazy where it takes like good 5, almost 10 minutes before it'll pick it up.
And then it picks all of them up.
Yep.
Yeah, that's server.
Yep. Because, like I say, they got Jumptown running, then they got, then they're doing the tech preview test. And which is not a bad thing, but I would rather they not run an event while they're doing the PTU test.
One of two.
Just my thought.
I know exactly where you're coming from.
Fracture mode on.
Because it does take away from the other players when that happens. Just so.
Yeah, I just tried scraping the Corvette, and it literally is not showing any process of any collection. It's showing it being taken off, but it's not collecting.
That's server issues.
Yep.
Because it was working fine until they brought out Jumptown. It was so bad Monday night that I just stopped. I said, I can't play this. I kept banging into not getting inventory and stuff like that. I couldn't play it. I said, no.
Yeah.
And usually I can tough it out, but it was way bad. that.
It's all right.
Let's see. Yes, now it's starting to pick up. Gotta let it sit for a minute.
Oh, I learned something else today too.
What's that?
You know the upper walkway in the salvage area?
Mm-hmm.
On the reclaimer? You can put size 16 crates up there.
Ooh. That's huge.
A little bit.
What I do love about this is you can be on the dark side of the planet and you can see the sun come up. It's the rotation of the planet is just amazing.
Yeah, I can see that.
Nice little field of having night over here. I don't know what This one I'm gonna call it. Spend some time with my wife. And my stepson and enjoy the evening.
Yep.
I understand. Before I have to get up and go juice work in the morning.
Really?
Yep. Tomorrow is Family Calamity is back, and it's a group mining, or group bounty hunting.
Okay. Group bounty hunting. Are you going to have fox and hounds kind of a thing, or are you just going to have potluck?
I'll do some... Do some bounties, do some, you know, the service beacons, and just have a good old time.
Okay. Sounds like fun.
Kind of staying away from Jump Town. I figure I'll do that next weekend. Before it goes away.
Yep. Give time for the... EPTU and the replication layer test.
Thank you. Yeah, have them get a few builds in before I do it. Because then we should see a all backers come in pretty soon. Hopefully.
Never know.
Very excited for the server meshing test. That is, and with the replication layer split, that's some good stuff right there.
I was looking at the cleanup options in personal. Right now they've got a Cuddy Black for 80,000. It'll fill up a 16 SCU crate. It's not bad money for that. I'm gonna jump off for the evening, man. Take it easy.
All right, take it easy, man. Good hearing from you.
Anytime. I'll be on a little bit more often.
All right.
Later.
Later.
launch complete. Landing gear up.
Travel complete.
proceed to assigned landing bay. Complete. Have a pleasant stay.
Welcome to the ASOP Vehicle Retrieval System.
Oops. I'll do this tomorrow. But anyway. Well, for those that dropped in, I hope you all enjoyed it. And tomorrow there's no SCL. Just Jump Town. Tomorrow is group bounty hunting. And it will be in the afternoon. So, everybody. Excuse me, have a good one, take care, and see you all tomorrow. Shadow Spectre 11 saying thank you to Brian and Tone for dropping in, and take care.
It was on earlier, it was fine. Hello, everybody.